Injuries are a part of every sport. Surgeries, the long process of rehab, missed games. A common injury in sport is a torn ACL. You can't play with a torn ACL and it will take from 6 to 12 months to recover from. Well, in this case, you can't tear what you don't have. Hey guys, hope you're all feeling great. This is Purple Prince and today I want to look at what happened to the man without ACLs, DeJuan Blair. DeJuan Blair was born on April 22, 1989 in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. You could say the basketball was in his blood, as both of his parents played basketball at Shenley High School. Attending the same high school as his parents and playing basketball for it, Blair scored 1,563 career points and led the team to an overall record of 103 wins and only 16 losses. He did suffer some injuries though. During his high school career, Blair underwent two surgeries on his ACLs. That didn't impact his popularity, as he was heavily recruited by a lot of schools. In the end, he chose University of Pittsburgh. In 2 years there, DeJuan Blair averaged 13.6 points and 10.7 rebounds. After 2 years in college, Blair declared for the 2009 NBA draft, and some projections thought he could be a late lottery pick. That was until the draft combine. The doctors performed a routine magnetic resonance imaging examination on his knees, and they discovered that Blair has no ACLs. Turns out, the ligaments weren't repaired, and the theory was that the grafts did not take and were absorbed by the body. So, basically, Blair's doctors didn't purposely remove his ACLs, but were unsuccessful at repairing the damaged ligaments, and might have caused the disappearance of the ACLs in their entirety. That obviously raised some concerns for a lot of teams who were high on drafting him. After all, ACL, you kinda need them. So in the end, he fell down the board, all the way to round 2, number 37, where the San Antonio Spurs picked him. At the time, they had great frontcourt depth and they could ease in Blair into his NBA career. He showed his value right away in his first preseason game. Blair grabbed 19 rebounds in 22 minutes. Then he had a double-double with 17 points and 10 rebounds in just 15 minutes. And sure, it was the preseason, but still, the Spurs felt confident about their pick. And the thing with Blair was that he was listed at 6'7", but he was closer to like 6'5", so he was greatly undersized for his position, yet here he was averaging double-digit rebounds without ACLs. The Spurs were so happy with Blair's performance, they gave him a 4-year contract worth $2.8 million. And I know it sounds very little when compared to nowadays contracts, but at that time for a second round pick, that was a very good deal. Blair had a memorable rookie season. Even though he played only 18.2 minutes per game, he participated in all 82 games, started 23 of them, and averaged 7.8 points and 6.4 rebounds. More so, he was the first rookie in Spurs history since Tim Duncan to record a 2020 game when he finished with 28 points and 21 rebounds in a win against OKC. Blair was invited to the rookie challenge and he dominated there as well, collecting 22 points and 23 rebounds, becoming the first player ever to have a 2020 game in a rookie challenge. By second NBA season, Blair had become the Spurs' starting power forward, but still played only around 20 minutes per game. He did do his job though, averaging about 9 points and a little more than 6 rebounds in his limited minutes. His tenure with the Spurs organization did go south though. The addition of Boris Diaw and emergence of Thiago Splitter eventually removed Blair from the starter's role. In his last season with the Spurs in 2013, Blair played in 61 games but started only 16 of them, and on average played just 14 minutes per game. By season's end, he was pretty much out of rotation. The Spurs went to the NBA Finals but lost to the Miami Heat. His next career stop was Dallas. He was a bench player there and in 78 games averaged 6.4 points and 4.7 rebounds. And after 1 year in Dallas, Blair went to the Wizards, where he played for 2 seasons, but in total participated in just 58 games, didn't start a single one, and averaged just 6.9 minutes per. After not receiving any solid offers from NBA teams, Blair went to China, where he averaged 24.1 points and 13.6 rebounds in 10 games before being cut from the team. Blair had some stints in D-League and even Argentina before his final stop in Italy, where he didn't even get to play because he got a 2-year suspension from FIBA for an anti-doping violation. The crazy thing is that Blair right now is just 31 years old, and he's been out of the NBA since 2016. So his last NBA game was played at a young age of 27. So if his NBA career is over, he has played in a total of 424 NBA games and has averaged 16.6 minutes, 6.8 points, and 5.1 rebounds per game. So what is Blair doing now? Unfortunately, in late 2019, his family suffered a tragedy when his father was shot to death, so no good news on that front. And as far as anything related to basketball, I don't think he's playing anywhere now, at least on a semi-professional level. He also hasn't been supremely active on his Twitter, so I guess he's just living a low-key life, and hopefully a happy and a healthy one. Thanks for watching the video, guys. Do you remember DeJuan Blair, or is it the first time you heard about him? Why do you think he had such a short career in the NBA? Please leave any thoughts about the subject in the comment section. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and stay healthy. This is Purple Prince, and I'm out.